Happy New Year, everybody. This is Mystery Espinoz X, and welcome back to some more Let's Play Batman Arkham Asylum. And in the last episode, we found the missing formula, but of course Batman had to burn it just in case, you know, anybody, if the wrong hands catch up to it, pretty much. So now we are continuing our search for Dr. Young because we think that she is in danger. And hopefully this recording session does way better than the last other three recording sessions. It's one of those days, everyone. It's one of those days and stuff. But hopefully everyone had a good New Year's, pretty much a good holiday. So now we are back at it again. Sorry it took a while for the next episode to upload. Again, I've been pretty busy, especially since during the holidays. You know, I really haven't had the time to record anything, but now, since the holidays are over, you know, it's that time of the month where they just start cutting hours, and I'm working less. So, yeah. So now I have the time to actually record something. Yay! Alright, let's go ahead and get this started, and something's going on. Why is it rain? Why did it say that we were in Wayne Manor, and why is it raining inside of the hallway? This is really weird. Crime Alley. Oh boy. It's one of those moments in every Batman media, movie, or video games. It's one of those where something particular happened in Bruce Wayne's life, you know, that changed him forever. And I think you guys know what I'm definitely talking about. It is, of course, the murder of his parents, and the sole reason why he became Batman, to, you know, strike vengeance upon those, pretty much. It happens in every Batman movie, video game. There's always gonna be that one moment where it does show off, you know, his parents being killed, a flashback at least, or, you know, an origin story, pretty much. Yeah. Poor Waynes. They never get a break, do they? It's funny because I remembered I was reading this thing in Facebook where I guess these cosplayers dressed up as, you know, the Waynes pretty much with a tuxedo and the woman dressed in like a dress. And they would, like, I guess, you know, in like they stop by with, they like go up to anybody dressed up as Batman and just, you know, fall like pretending like they're dead and stuff. It's funny. So yeah, it's not funny, but I mean, what am I saying? Oh boy. Sorry, I'm really tired. It's not funny. It's not funny. Death is not a funny thing. What I meant to say was that the thing that they did was funny, you know, stopping by every single, it's, how do I say this, it's sad. Yes, it's sad what happened to his parents and stuff, but I mean, what they did, it's pretty entertaining, pretty much. I mean, just seeing the reaction of the people dressed up as Batman, pretty much. Hopefully everyone's guessing what I'm saying. I don't know, but anyway, we are in Scarecrow mission number two, Scarecrow sequence number two. This one's a little more challenging than the last one, because there is actually a lot more stuff to do here and more obstacles as well. Of course, the last one, it showed off pretty much his explosive gel. This time, this will show off more of our bat claw, just by pulling down those crates and hiding behind them, because we do not want to get hit by the spotlight or the beam of eyes Scarecrow has. And again, Rocksteady did a beautiful job on Scarecrow. I just love seeing that costume of his and stuff. It's just awesome. So yeah. And then, again, hopefully everyone had a good New Year's. It is 2017. Of course, it is time to finish up with this Let's Play. Hopefully that I'll get more time recording these because I do have to go back into playing the game again because there was a little hiccup. There was a glitch in the game, and I guess, I don't know, I have to go back and just starting all over. I know it sucks, but I'm not, discontinuing with the Let's Play. I don't want to do a Strider again. I mean, I don't want to put this on hold like I did with Strider because of it, because I love this game and I want to continue doing this Let's Play. But yeah. And this one's gonna be a special episode actually, because it is 58 minutes long, nearly almost like 2 minutes till like an hour. It's like almost an hour long video pretty much. This is pretty much the longest video I had ever done, besides the finale for the for Street Fighter V story mode, which was 55 minutes long, I believe. But this one takes the cake as long as video, and oh my gosh, we got our first game over in the game. It is actually creepy right here. Just the light blends in with the darkness. Just, oh my god, that's so creepy, but yet so awesome. But yeah, all right, so let's go ahead and continue on. Luckily, you don't have to start all over, we just continue where we had left off, so that's a good thing. That's what I like about it. Because at first, when I played this game, I was all like, oh, I died, I probably have to start all over from the beginning. But nope. Nope. They continue on from where we left off in the Scarecrow sequence. Scarecrow segments. Yeah, whatever you'd like to call it. I just call it Scarecrow segments. So yeah. I almost got caught there. Wow, I actually got it away from there. So yeah, but like I mentioned before, after this game, definitely gonna do Arkham City next, and then of course I'm gonna go ahead and get started with Ultimate Marvel's Capcom 3 as a side project, because I need side projects. I've pretty much been thinking about what should I let's play as a side LP, and luckily, I've decided to do Ultimate Marvel's Capcom 3, and after that start off with my main LP, which is Arkham City next. And I want to save Uncharted Drake's Fortune for a main LP as well. I don't want to do a side LP on Uncharted because it's pretty long, and I just, for now, like when it comes to side LPs, I usually do like short games, like maybe like a 6 hour, 5 hour game at least. Or maybe one that's at least maybe, I don't know, maybe like really not that long of a game. But we'll see what. So pretty much, and then after Arkham City, of course, I'll do Uncharted. Let's say that, and then when I do Uncharted, still thinking about a side LP, but right now I just need to focus on this game in general. So yeah. All right, so we're almost done. We actually fell off. I don't know why. I literally puzzled why I fell down. Okay, just wait until this thing. Okay, well, we have to wait until Scarecrow mostly, because we don't want to just wait until he turns around. Okay, I think we're good. All right, let's do this. We'll also wait for the clock too. There we go. All right. Actually, you want to hide behind here too, because he's gonna look back. Stealth is key. All right, we're good. Let's go ahead and go. Go, 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 go. Ah. Ooh, that was close. All right. Just wait a while. Cause I don't. The thing is, like, I don't want to rush it now. I just, it has to come with patience, pretty much. Just wait until he actually turns around, and it'll take a while. But we're almost there, everyone. There goes a bat signal. You actually want to wait here too. It's patience, guys. Patience. Okay. Yeah, we got it. Yep, that's it. That's how you complete the segment number two of Scarecrow. Bye bye, Scarecrow. We're not afraid of you. It's like they're paying a homage to. I mean, I know Scarecrow has always been that villain, mostly, striking fear into his victims. Just like how Batman does as well, but Scarecrow's approach into fear is more like deadly in a way. But I mean, it's like Scarecrow is pretty much this, like they paid homage to pretty much Freddy Krueger in this game of Scarecrow, because if you notice, Freddy Krueger's weakness is pretty much not being afraid of him, and some that's and some, blah, 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 being afraid of him and stuff. And of course, hitting that light. I think I remember it. I seen one movie of Freddy Krueger where, I don't know, one of the teenagers hit him with some type of light, and then he just started, dying and stuff. I think Rocksteady paid homage to that. I'm not sure, but I mean, I always known Scarecrow as the fear guy, pretty much. But anyway, now that we've completed that, we're gonna go ahead and start continuing our search for Dr. Young, because she is in danger, and I think I turned a wrong turn, pretty much. Let me see here. Pull up the map. All right, cool. We're going the right way, so that's good. Also, there's another Riddler challenge here. Oh wait, but first we're introduced to new enemies. These enemies that are holding shock batons. Now, in order to defeat these enemies, you're gonna have to jump by pressing X or double tap X or A if you're playing this on the Xbox, and just hitting them. But anyway, here we have a cool little Easter egg right here, or a Riddler challenge. These goggles and these claws right here, that belongs to Catwoman. As you can see, the plaque name that's right there, Catwoman. That's awesome right there. When I saw that, I'm like, OMG. Like, is Catwoman in the game? No, she wasn't. They show equipment from Batman's villains, but they're not in the game until the other until Arkham City. But I don't want to spoil anything from Arkham City. But here's Dr. Young. We knew it. Zaz is after her. Now we gotta go save her. Alright. So pretty much what you wanna do here is aim your batarang, of course. And then wait until his head pops up and then just hit him. And then there we go. Dr. Young is safe. Oh no. Dr. Young. Ah, damn it. Shoots. Now what? Batman always comes up with a plan B no matter what happens. Just goes to show you, like this game does a pretty well thing about it too, is you can't save them all. And this game does pretty well about it too. I mean, I know it's like a bad thing and stuff, but it's pretty much what a superhero is about. Like, if you've seen The Dark Knight, I'm just pretty much gonna say without spoiling anything, but possible spoilers, for those who haven't seen the Dark Knight trilogy yet or any of the movies. But when Alfred told him, you can't save them all, you gotta be willing to make those sacrifices. That's what defies Batman. And it's true. I mean, being a superhero, for those who've read the comic books or, watched the movies, you can't save them all. I'm not saying necessarily like, oh, you could become a superhero. You could. I mean, if you're crazy about that, if you're crazy enough to be a real life vigilante, not saying don't. I'm encouraging everyone, don't do it. Trust me, don't do it. But I mean, I know the whole thing. How do I say this without offending anyone? I mean, it's your life. I won't judge what you do and stuff. It's your life. But anyway, back to what I was saying. If you're willing to become a superhero, you got to be willing to make those sacrifices. You're going to make a lot of mistakes. But the good you do will far outweigh the bad. And I'm quoting this from Arrow and the first episode of The Flash, too. You just got to be strong-minded and be willing to make those sacrifices, pretty much. And that's what Batman does, He is willing to make those sacrifices. Sure, it may hurt him down along the road, but still, he's still strong enough to just push forward. And that's what I like about Batman. But super like when I was a kid, like, oh my God, I wish I was a superhero, but now I don't want to be a superhero. I'm not willing to make those sacrifices at all. I hate seeing loved ones go, It sucks. But yeah. But I mean, yeah, this game, this is why I love this game, dude. Like, there's so much, detail and everything. And as soon as you walk, and the more you progress in the game, you see the body count. Like, you see the deceased security guards and the police officers. And it sucks. It really does. But yeah, this is why this makes this game series great. So yeah. Alright, so you got two more. Now these guys are together. So this one's a little weird because this isn't like a meany little segment. Oh, he caught me. All right, you know what? Let him go, Batman. You're gonna get die. Fudge. Damn it. Oh man, you took too long on that one. I should have waited. But I mean, the best strategy to do that when they're together is to knock someone out with a batarang and just take out the person that's, still conscious, and then just wait until the guy starts waking up, and then, yeah, then you'll, go for the hit. So yeah, all right, let's go ahead and do this again. The second game over. Wow, we are failing in this episode, everyone. We are definitely are. Oh man. All right. Now this guy right here, he's by himself. Always take out the people that are beat by themselves, no groups at all. You'll be able to like take them out like that, like take them all out like that. It's pretty much like in the first episode too, like they're how they're separated. You just gotta take out the one that's, behind the rest. So, but like I did it before. Okay, let me see here. What could I do here? All right, they're starting to go into groups. They notice that one of them is already taken out. All right, yeah. All right. I could just do that. since they're together, the impact of the glide kick will definitely knock out the other person since he's nearby. But yep, there you go. All right, now you gotta. Now, next up is to find the warden. I forgot to mention we scanned his cane, the top of his cane and stuff. And now we gotta find him, which is the traces of his blood. Okay. There's a lot of blood spill on this part right here. But yeah, when it comes to these, you just gotta, you know, follow the traces. I know it sucks because, I mean, and I remember they did an honest trailer of this game too, where they said they were like, the atmosphere of the game is so beautiful, but then it'll be ruined by, you know, just being blue. Be prepared to see a lot of blue, pretty much. Yeah, it's true. Like, you mostly use your detective mode throughout the whole game. And there was rumor going around that the next Batman game, which was Arkham City, that they thought about, you know, having like a time limit for the detective mode, which was pretty stupid, but luckily they didn't go with it, so that's a good thing. So, yeah. But, I mean, it's cool I did say I was not going to mention the sequels, but I'm not going to do it anyway. But, yeah, I mean, yeah, detective mode kind of kills it, you know, just looking at how beautiful the atmosphere of this game is and stuff. But, I mean, it's whatevers. All right, so there's actually two people with guns here. Just take out that one and take out that one, and then you're good to go to, or not. I think that guy, yeah. When the enemies will dodge your batterings, usually when they already know that you're there, they'll, you know, evade it sometimes. But if you do it quickly, then they won't. Is he okay? You can't get me. None of these guys can get me. Ha! Also, when it comes to the free flow mode, be cautious when doing the ground takedowns as well. Because if you do take too long, they will hit you. And it'll break your combo too. Alright, we took care of those guys. Oh man. Let's see how long we have. 22 minutes. So yeah, and I am playing this while I'm recording too. Okay, there's a Riddler trophy. Like again, I said before, I'm not going to get all of them. But let me see if I can remember how to. Forget it. I'm not going to try to get it. Alright. Oh, yeah. You go up here. And then the trail still goes. But, let me see. So, question of the day will be, what is your favorite Batman story arc? In any comic book, let me know in the comments below. Personally, my favorite Batman story arc has to be Batman Hush. It's one of those comics where, you know, it truly defines who Batman is, and you know, you actually get to see all of his all of his villains. Actually, it's more of like a anniversary type issue, but yeah, it's really awesome. I remembered I actually read it twice. I've had the graphic novel for it too, but I don't know, I sold it because, I don't know, it was just collecting dust. I mean, now I kind of regret it, and now I'm actually keeping my comic books too and stuff. But actually, like, during the first issue, Batman actually goes up against Superman, and, you know, he falls in love with Catwoman, which, you know, I totally, like, you know, what the cool kids say nowadays, I ship them. Pretty much saying that I agree with the I agree for them being in a relationship pretty much and stuff. So yeah. Alright. Damn. Wow. I literally, oh my, wow. I literally went in circles. I'm so annoyed. I'm really sorry about this, everyone. Wow. I literally went in circles. Wow. Okay, let's go ahead and just go outside and rethink our steps. But anyway, oh wow, dude, I can't believe that happened. Damn, I'm really sorry about this, everyone. But anyway, Hush, yeah, like he faces off against Superman, and then he falls in love with Catwoman. I mentioned already this, but yeah, I would always wanted them to be in a relationship because you know they're like the perfect couple. I mean, Catwoman is this anti-hero, you know, that goes out and robs people. She, you know, crosses the line between good and evil. And Batman's this hero, you know, the protector of Gotham and stuff. And that sounds like a perfect pair. And, you know, their chemistry together is just awesome. Especially in Batman Returns, dude. Oh my gosh, it was just awesome. And you know, in Hush, you know, they go on a full relationship. You know, they actually fight crime together and stuff. They face off against the villains, and it's just awesome. It really is. And then Batman was actually comfortable telling him who he really is, which is Bruce Wayne. What's this? Batman is Bruce Wayne? Yes, Batman is Bruce Wayne. But anyway, even said that Batman already knew who she was, which is Selina Kyle. What? Selina Kyle is Catwoman? Of course. But Batman already knew who she was, but she didn't know who he was, you know, their secret identities pretty much. And then yeah, it's and then he actually fools on tells her like yeah she like removes her removes his ca he removes his cowl and then she's like whoa Bruce Wayne this makes more things interesting. All right, what you got for us now, Joker? But yeah, Hush is just a really awesome story arc, you know, probably the best one of the best Batman story arcs. But what is your guys' favorite story arc? You know, is it Hush or is it you know him going up against the aliens? Or Long Halloween. Tell me in the comments below. I like to hear your guys' story. But yeah. What's this? Oh, it's a receipt. But yeah. Movie? My favorite Batman movie? Well, I mean, I do like the Dark Knight trilogy. I mean, I do, especially the Dark Knight, the one with Heath Ledger as Joker, but I actually enjoy Batman vs Superman, actually. I mean, Ben Affleck played a good Batman. I'll admit that. He did awesome as Batman. It's, you know, they drew inspiration from, you know, the Arkham series in a way. They actually, like, I know Batman vs. Superman, like, this is what I think about Batman vs. Superman pretty much. The movie was good. I'll admit it was good. Sure, it can be a mess. It could be confusing at times and stuff. but I just thought it was really good. Just for the sole fact that, you know, Gal Gadot did a great Wonder Woman. And Ben Affleck did a great Batman. And it was just awesome. And, you know, I really enjoy that, you know, warehouse scene where, you know, they show off Batfleck, what people are calling him, Batfleck. It's Batman and Affleck put together, pretty much. And it's, he was just awesome, you know, when they showed that warehouse scene where he's just fighting those Russians. It was just, well, not Russians, because there was one other person. What I meant to say was, you know, the henchman that was working for Lex Luthor. That warehouse scene was just awesome, and I could tell that they drew inspiration from the Arkham series, you know, when he goes up on the ceiling. And then just, you know, disarms all his gad all their guns and stuff. It was just awesome. But yeah. But especially Lex Luthor, Jesse Eisenberg's Lex Luthor. Oh boy, where do I begin with this one? He felt more like the Riddler than Lex Luthor. Of course, my cousin told me that's how he began, pretty much. He reads comic books too. But I mean, I always thought of Lex Luthor as just brilliant mind instead of just like going crazy. I know he's crazy and stuff, you know, all the plans he comes up with just to defeat Superman and stuff, or get into his head pretty much. Hold on, we got a tape here. He's crazy. But anyway, I mean, I always thought of Lex Luthor as this brilliant mind and genius, and you know, yeah, he's also crazy too and stuff, but I didn't think he would be that crazy. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, Jesse Eisenberg did pretty good, but it would have been better if it was put on like the Riddler costume instead of the Riddler, instead of Lex Luthor. He would have been awesome as the Riddler, and they probably got an other actor who to play Lex Luthor or something. A lot of people like to call him Lex Luthor Jr. because they want the senior, you know, to be the actual Lex Luthor. But yeah, but I mean, overall, the movie I thought was good, you know. Sure, it was a mess, but I enjoyed it still. I mean, it's one of those movies that, you know, was just split down the middle. Some people loved it, some people hated it. They're pretty much in between the middle, saying it was a meh and stuff. But I thought it was good. I really did. Especially, I like to say that Ben Affleck's my favorite Batman of all time, for sure. I mean, you gotta admit, he did awesome. He really did. He pulled off Batman. Despite, you know, early on when it was announced that he was gonna play Batman, of course, like a lot of people hated it, you know, but you gotta give him people a chance, guys. It's a lot of people said about Heath Ledger as the Joker, and you know, a lot of people said that about Michael Keaton being Batman. And get this. This was back in 1989, back when the internet wasn't the way it is now. But anyway, Poison Ivy.
Just stay where you are. Last thing I need is you running free.
Poor children. Yeah, we don't want to deal with your problems, Ivy. But anyway, I mean, yeah, this is like back when, you know, I mean, the internet was only back then, I guess, was only used. Well, I mean, the internet really didn't exist that time. It really didn't. No, they're just people. I don't know. I've heard that. Oh boy, I literally need to look these things up. But anyway, I mean, this is back when, you know, the internet didn't happen at all and stuff. And you know, no one could have like wrote comments like we do now, you know, saying, you know, when they hear news about something, pretty much. You guys know what I'm saying.
you all day. What a riot! And speaking of riots, here's a bit of civil unrest I cooked up just for you.
What are you waiting for? Cut me free! He's taken control of the security overrides. I have the sequence generator, but without the terminal in my office, it's useless.
Your terminal is destroyed. Give me the sequencer.
What? Oh, yes, of course. It's useless. Half the code won't get you anywhere. We're trapped in here.
There's always a way out. Always.
But anyway, yeah, I just, during that cutscene, I had to look up. But I guess the internet didn't really start around until, 1990. But this was back when social media never existed either. I mean, before, where we're allowed to actually write comments on some new stuff. Like, just imagine if, the first Batman movie wouldn't come out until, I don't know, say back in 2005, the same time Batman Begins came out, or 2007 or 2008, and if people hear, and if, say, Michael Keaton was actually more, like, younger, say, I guess the same year Christian Bale was when he was cast as Batman. Just imagine how many people would react to that. And, like, when the movie would actually come out and people would just, actually start liking Mike Keaton. Just imagine. Just really imagine. And then, of course, don't let this guy fool you. That is definitely Clayface. When I saw that, I was like, it would have been awesome if, he would, without his, his disguises that he does. But yeah, if you actually, first he was the warden, but then when you turn around, he transforms into Commissioner Gordon, which is pretty awesome. But anyway, yeah, just imagine if, actually social media would exist around that time. Imagine how many people would just react. Like, they would comment, like how people commented when they heard Ben Affleck was casted. That would have been crazy. But yeah, I mean, you gotta admit that Ben Affleck was awesome. And of course, Joker released the crazies, and of course, new enemies as well. Alright, so now we are gonna introduce to, I guess, the insane people. And then there goes Harley Quinn. To defeat them, you can't really go on full-on free flow combat with them. You just gotta, with one punch they'll be out. But you also gotta ground take down them as well. When they come at you, you gotta counter them, and then he'll take them down.
Come and get me, Bats. I double dare ya.
Alrighty, Harley. Oh snap, we gotta go. He unleashed. Look at Harley just swinging. That's crazy. All right, now we got going through a gauntlet right here, and then of course you don't want them to get a hands on the guns neither. Boop. You come here. Hold on. I'm busy. No getting guns. These guys do not want to play fair, neither. Okay, the first one's free. Alright, round two. Fight! Okay, that one was for free, too. Okay, you know what? Okay, now you guys are taking full advantage of free stuff. Ugh, bone crushings, dude. It's just awesome. Yet, and sick at the same time. Alrighty, they are taken care of.
Was that as easy as it looked? Huh. Well, it won't be so easy trying to catch me.
Harley Quinn got away. Great. Alright, now you gotta find a way into... But anyway, I totally forgot to mention this too. But anyway, if you actually go to this... Tommy Gun, you actually unlock the Ventriloquist's bio, which is, you know, the holder of Scarface the puppet. But anyway, we are introduced to a new gadget, which I forgot to mention, is of course this device that lets you unlock locked security gates or doors. And the way to use these is just to toggle around the joysticks. Both of them, actually, which is cool, and it actually shows the same motion as you use it for your joystick, which is awesome. But anyway, we could unlock a new gadget. Let's go ahead and unlock the special combo boost. Alright, let's go ahead and continue how long we are. 42 minutes. We're almost at the end of the video. Boy, for some reason it feels like I'm only doing like at least a 20 minute video. But no, it's actually more longer. Alright. So let's go ahead and unlock this door. See what's... You also may notice that there's actually a lot more Easter eggs, you know, after you pass this game, and I'll talk about them later as well. Probably do like a bonus episode. It's really funny because whenever I do Let's Plays and they say I'm going to do a bonus episode of something, I really don't do it. That's the thing. I think I need to make that one of my New Year's resolutions for this channel is actually do the bonus episodes of the games that I was going to do a bonus episode of. I really need to do that. I remembered I actually looked back at some of my old videos. There's moments where like, I'm going to do a bonus episode of this. But I really don't. Like, I just go ahead and like skip through it. Yeah, that's the thing. Once I finish the Let's Play, I just like to move to like new projects and stuff. And, you know, I really never noticed that I say that I want to do a bonus episode. Which is, I literally need to go back to the games and do that. But yeah, but this time I will legitimately do a bonus episode of this, showing off, you know, the challenge modes as well. Alright, so we can't really go through here because the floor is pretty much electric. We can't go to the floor because we'll get electrocuted pretty much. So, what you want to do is, of course, go right here. Actually, I think we've already been in this spot. Did we? Oh no, I think we're good. Here comes another crazy person. Stay down. I need to blow my nose. Ooh. I know what? I honestly never knew there was a person there. I just... That's crazy. Alright, if you go here, there's a Riddler trophy there. Was I here? I'm not sure. Was I here before? I'm really confused right now. Sorry guys, I'm literally trying to remember where I have to go, because I think I did. Oh god, my nose. Hold on everyone. Alright guys, we're back. But anyway, yeah, sorry, I Literally trying to remember. Oh, you know what? Nope, nope. Okay, I got it right. All right, we're good. Alright, so what you want to do is, of course, save these guys, but be careful because the floor is electrocuted and, of course, there's water too, and even though, of course, water and electricity doesn't go well, if you played or watched the Pokemon cartoons, you would learn too. Water conducts electricity. Alright, and of course, we are timed. Actually, we don't want to go there because that's where... you just wanna, oh yeah, that, okay, I remember. All right, since that is done, now we could free him, and then what we wanna do now is try to free this person here, trying to remember where to go. That, right? No. Okay. Let's see here again. All right. Well, it was under my nose too. Oh, great. I'm really like a fool of fail this episode. Alright, now we got that. Now we could defuse that part right there. Got 50 seconds left. We're good. We're definitely good. Alright, nice, nice, nice. And then we're good. Now we gotta defuse the bomb now. Oh great, we got 30 seconds left. We gotta defuse the bomb. Oh no, we gotta get out of here first. Oh my gosh. It's been a while, everyone. It has been a while. Alright. Got it. Alright, cool. Let's get out of here now. Get out of here now.
Oh, I thought we were both gonna die in there. You're safe now.
You going after that crazy witch? I saw her heading out of the door as we got out of the room.
She won't get away. I'll stop her and then her boyfriend.
Good. Listen, I'll go try and get the ventilation system working. If you find her, don't go easy on her. For me.
Alright, now that we got that, now you gotta find Harley Quinn. No, that's that. Just those moments in this game is just could really keep your suspense up, especially your adrenaline as well, which is crazy. All right, let's go ahead and start going here. Okay, it's almost at least 50 minutes, so 8 more minutes until this video's over. Yeah, this has pretty gone long. I'm already to the point where, I'm just to the point where the commentary's dying. But actually, if you come over here, this is the cell of villain known as Calendar Man. I really didn't know who Calendar Man was until, you know... I've actually played this game because Calendar Man's that lesser known villain in Batman's in the DC universe, like the list villain, yeah, to be exact. But yeah, he's still crazy. Actually, if you come here as well, this one belongs to Two-Face. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of cells that belongs to villains, and you'll, and if you know, if you read the Batman comic books, you'll know who it is, or the, like, the cartoon as well. And this one has actually the Riddler's, actually. Oh, but anyway, I think we already unlocked his bio anyway from the first, second episode. Oh man, sorry. Alright. Oh, I'm definitely going the right way. I don't want to go back. Alright. Let me see here. This is probably the last time I'm ever going to do a video this long. I already do apologize, everyone. Oh, okay. Now I get it. Now you go up here. Nope. Wow. Wow. That's crazy. All right, we got it. Gotcha. Okay, now I think we definitely have to go back upstairs, downstairs actually. Yeah, right here. There we go. Yeah, I remember this part. This is actually one of my favorite parts in the game. As you can see here, this cell belongs to Mr. Freeze, hinting all the ice that's coming out of it.
Excellent. I'll leave it to you then, my dear.
And then here comes the guys. Alright, let's do this. Now, when it comes to this part in the game, you can see there's at least three of the floors that have the electric panels, and you gotta, as soon as they light up, you gotta escape or else you'll get shocked, as those guys got shocked just now. So you gotta get away quickly. As soon as you see one floor panel start getting electrocuted, you gotta move out of there. Luckily that they're just electrocuting that floor panel. Nice, we're keeping up the combos. I'm trying to keep it up. Alright, here comes more. Yay! These guys have the shock. This guy has the shock on the top. Oh, gotta get out of here. Ah! Ooh, that was close. Oh my god! I think we killed a person! Oh, damn, dude. Batman literally just killed a guy back there, guys. Oh, dang. Sorry. Alright, we're at a 7 combo right now. 8. Ah, dang it. Broke it. Ah, shoot, sorry. You know what? Oh, okay. Oh, snap. I gotta get out of here. Ooh, that was a close one. I think everyone got up with me. What am I doing? I'm not playing right now. Gosh, this episode is full of fail today. And I literally killed a person, too. Ooh, gotta get out. Taste of your own medicine. Yes, he did it.
I'm on my way now.
Oops, change of plans, kiddo.
But I tried my best.
Sorry, but there is no prize for second place. I'm afraid you're off the party list. Better luck next time.
No! Die, you big ugly bat!
Ooh.
Hey, hands off the merchandise. That's my party list.
Quiet. Why the smiles next to certain names?
You're the detective, you tell me. He'll get me out. You'll see. Yeah. You'll see.
Well, that's all she wrote for Harley Quinn.
Oracle, I'm done.
You know, that's literally like one of my favorite segments. They also did a challenge mode for this particular map too, which is really awesome as well. One of my favorite challenge maps too. But anyway, now that we got Harley Quinn's prints, now we get to follow where
the gardens are showing up hot. Something bad is happening there.
Right, so now we gotta go to the botanical gardens. I do believe that's where Poison Ivy is as well. So yeah, alrighty then everyone, well, I'm gonna go ahead and stop the video here. Oh wow, this is pretty long too, so yeah. But hopefully everyone enjoyed, hopefully everyone did, and sorry again for not talking as much as I wished I could in this episode. But yeah, it's really long. But anyway, this has been Mysterious Pinos X saying goodnight, good morning, good day, whatever time you're watching this video. And I will see you guys in the next one. Alright guys. Bye.